Co-author of The Post-American Presidency, the Obama Administration's War on America, Pamela Geller, and civil rights attorney David Lane. Guys, welcome to the program. David, I'll start with you. Is Sharia law moderate in your mind?
I'm no expert in Sharia law, so I'm really not qualified to comment on whether
you.
It is or it is not.
Well, then you really can't comment.
Well, I don't know that you're an expert on this either, Sean, but I'll listen.
Well, if you don't know about Sharia law, then frankly, I don't even think you're qualified to comment on the issue. Let me educate you, because obviously you need an education. Where women get stoned to death for adultery, where women who are raped need four male eyewitnesses, where women are forced to wear clothing that they may not necessarily want to wear, where women can't drive, where women can't get an education, where women can't be seen in public.
I am against all those things, Sean.
Oh, you do know those things.
I'm against all those things. I'm against all those things.
You're against all those things. So then you're against what this is.
I'm against all those things.
This imam wants America to be Sharia compliant.
Well, I believe in the Constitution of the United States of America.
Well, he obviously
doesn't.
And we should
be constitutionally compliant.
Okay. That's not constitutional. He wants America to be Sharia compliant, Pamela, which is the point. He's making my point.
If that is a correct, characterization of what he wants.
This is not a constitutional issue. This is not a religious liberties issue. This is a matter of common decency. And we have this extraordinary sensibility to the demands of the Muslim world, and there's no reciprocity. If he was genuine in wanting to improve the image of Islam, he would move that mosque. It is an insult. It is deeply offensive, sir. Deeply offensive. And it is deliberately provocative.
Can I talk about the First Amendment for a minute?
You don't have to be politically correct.
Make you happy to set up a mosque or a church or a synagogue anywhere in the United States of America.
Let me ask you a question.
The most
anti-Islamic
person
shrine
in New York City.
Would you put a Ku Klux Klan shrine at the 16th Street Baptist Church in Alabama?
Do you know
what
I've
about
done?
The convent outside
the
of
Klan.
Horse fights? They did not put the
I've
convent outside
the KKK.
Of horse fights. Would you put
well,
it right?
If you want me to talk, I'll say something. But,
it's not a religious issue.
Yeah, I've represented the KKK and gotten them a marching permit on Martin Luther King's birthday because I believe in free speech. I believe in the First Amendment right to freedom of religion.
Let me ask you a question.
And if they want to put up a mosque in New York City,
you want to discuss that. Let me ask you, Counselor, a question.
They should be able to.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think it's radical not to condemn the terror group Hamas? Do you think it's radical to accuse America 19 days after 9/11 of being an accessory to what happened on 9/11? Do you think it's radical to say Osama bin Laden is made in the USA?
We could debate every one of those statements.
Well, answer the question. That's the point.
Whether it's radical or not is not the question, Sean. The question is, does the First Amendment allow radical speech? The answer is yes.
It is the question. This is the guy that's spearheading the effort. And you don't have the moral courage. You do not have the moral courage to condemn what obviously needs to be condemned.
I think you're a radical, but I would fight for your right to speak on
national television. And what have I ever said that's radical?
Television.
I don't want Sharia law in America. I love the U.S.
That's
Constitution.
You want your version of your radical position.
What
and
is it? What's radical?
If anybody tried to shut you up, Sean, I would even represent you.
I'm not talking about shredding our Constitution and putting Sharia law as the law of the land in America as he is. I am not unwilling to condemn terror groups like Hamas that want to wipe Israel off the map.
That's
I don't blame America for what happened
about,
on 9/11.
Sean.
You're
you
supporting a guy.
It, and he gets to have his position.
He should be investigated. Imam Raouf spoke at an event sponsored by Hizbut al-Tahrir. This is a pan-Islamic revolutionary Muslim revolutionary that wants to install a caliphate in the world. The fact that it's named Cordoba is symbolic of Islamic conquest in the West.
So you want to shut him down.
Can I speak? Muslim armies invaded Spain in 7/11, and that's when Christians and Jews lived under dimitude and were denied basic human rights. There's a big message in Cordoba Institute.
So you don't
like
this guy.
And what I'm saying is that he's being dishonest.
Publish a book.
I did publish a book.
That's
the Post-American Presidency.
People should buy your book, read it, and then they should listen to this guy decide who's right, who's wrong. That's what the First Amendment is all about.
It's not a religious issue. Why there? I'm asking you as one decent American to another who believes in freedom, as a constitutional lawyer,
freedom for
I'm asking you a question. Why there? Why put a provocative mega mosque
because in the United States of America,
at the burial ground,
of Ground
Zero,
you want me to answer your question?
Trample on the grief of 9/11 families and all Americans.
Because
let's be honest, we're all 9/11 families. They just took the hit for us. That's all.
Okay. Let me just say this: in America, we don't stereotype people to the point where if you're Muslim, you must be a terrorist. And
wait,
I'm sorry about offense that a mosque is going
to
cause.
We got
to
break here.
If it's built,
why don't you have the moral? Courage, counselor, to condemn Hamas?
I condemn terrorism in any form.
Okay, this imam does not. Why don't you have the moral courage to say that anyone that says
we're an I'm simply saying he doesn't have to in America. He can support Hamas. He can stand on a platform and say, I love Hamas. I love terrorism. He's allowed to do that in a free country.
And if he does, then you become a threat to the rest of society, don't you? If you support terrorism, you are a threat to the rest of society, aren't you?
You know what? The First Amendment says you can say anything you want.
The First Amendment has limits. You can't threaten
me. Shut him up.
And if you're supporting terrorism, you're threatening the rest of society. Even you should be able to figure that out.
And I suppose if you support Islam, under your rubric, you're a threat to society because you're probably a terrorist. We're talking about putting up a mosque near the 9/11 site.
No, we're talking about a radical imam.
He should go to jail.
Time to check in with Greta Van Susteren for a sneak peek at what's coming up on the record. Greta, hello.
Wow, good evening, Sean.